Hey guys, so the update that we were waiting for is finally here. Thanks to the Good Luck 2018 application, we have our first look at Samsung's way of integrating the gesture support in the Experience UI. Now, this all started with iPhone 10, where Apple introduced the navigation gesture system for this no home button, no chin design. And obviously, from that, we got the update to the Android P as well, where Google integrated the navigation gestures. So from that, it moved to the third-party manufacturers as well. We have seen companies like OnePlus and Vivo implementing the navigation gesture-based system on their phone, potentially replacing the navigation bar that we are used to on Android. So with all this gesture stuff that is going around, Samsung still stuck with its navigation bar keys. So we got the home, the back, and the multitasking key. And now, thanks to the new update with the Good Luck application, we have our first look at Samsung's way of implementing the gesture-based system to the Experience UI, which will most probably be on the future Samsung phones such as the Galaxy Note 9 with the updated UI. So now Samsung has updated the one-handed plus operation mode and added a new feature here, which is called as swipe function. So this is where you're going to see all of your navigation gesture settings. And Samsung is basically utilizing its main design weapon, which is its edge display, giving us three type of edge gestures to basically replace or add alongside with this navbar key. So let me just quickly show you how this works. Swiping horizontal on the edge mark will take you to the back, so it acts as a back key. Swiping diagonally at the bottom will take you to your home screen, which means it is the replacement for the home button. And swiping diagonally upward will take you to your recents tab or multitasking area, where you can see all of your open application. So again, these are the three types of swipe gestures we have that I just showed you. We got the horizontal direction, which acts as a back key, diagonal up for recent key or multitasking area, diagonal down will take you to your home screen. Now you can actually customize these as well. If you want to have the back key with the diagonal up, then you can do that. But as the time I'm using these gestures on my Galaxy S9 Plus, I gotta say the default way is the best, which I'm gonna recommend to you guys as well if you're gonna try it out. But pretty much Samsung is giving you the ability to have gestures without actually getting rid of the navigation bar or navigation buttons that you're used to. So you can still use them if you want to, but a lot of times when we have the full screen mode on, we have to swipe here. So instead of swiping on this, you can just swipe on the edge, and that will take you to your home screen, or you're gonna go to back or the recent tab. You can do that by swiping on the edge of your display. Now there is also another option, which is called as use long swipe. So you can, now apart from having the short swipes, you can also turn on something called long swipe, which allows you to set up further more actions to the gestures. So as you can see, I have set the, so for example, the diagonal up has been set to screen off. So with a long swipe, I actually have to hold my finger for like 1 second, and then it takes that action. So let me just show you here, diagonal up, and I hold it, and as you can see, the screen is now off. In the same way, I've set the horizontal direction to my previous application. So I was using Instagram. I'm gonna go back here. As you can see, horizontal direction as you set to previous app. If I go and hold for a couple of seconds, or like 1 second, as you can see, it takes me back to my previous application, which is really, really cool. So we're actually getting total of 6 gestures, and you can set different functions to each of the gestures individually, which is really, really cool. Now again, all of this with your native navbar key still there, so if you're gonna use that, you can do that as well. Now obviously, you can customize the edge touch point here. I've set it all the way down so I can easily access it without any problem, but you can customize it completely if you want to. So you can have it on left if you are lefty, or you can have it on left/right. So now it appears on left and right as well, which is pretty cool because now you don't have to hold your phone with right hand. I mean, whatever hand you're using, you will be able to use the gestures. And of course, when you use the gesture, it does vibrate, so you can set the vibration level as well. Transparency, if you want to make make it more visible. You can have it all the way on low so that it pops up more so that you can easily see it. And then of course you can set the size of this as well. If you want to increase the size, you can do that. You can set its position as well. If you want to move it up or down, you can do it with this one. You can also increase the width area of this as well. So if you're having trouble touching it, you can do that. And then of course swipe action distance is also customizable, so you can have small or you can have a large distance action if you want to. Whatever floats your boat, you can pretty much customize everything with this swipe point or edge point or gesture point, whatever you want to call it. So it's completely customizable. And one of the great things about this gesture thing is that on a third-party application such as Instagram, if I open up a certain picture on iOS, you can actually go back by just swiping. While you can't do that on Android, which basically pisses me off, but thanks to this new gesture thing, we can actually go back by just, you know, swiping. So no need to bring the navbar keys. Everything is controllable via this edge gestures. Now, if you want to check out my full review of the Good Lock features, you can check out the card right now. I've basically done a full review of all the new features that we get, such as the new customizable lock screen with the shortcuts, as well as a new customizable quick setting area. So be sure to check that out. And I also showed you guys how to install it on your Samsung phone. Now, moving on to the next update, which is with the clock face. Now, Samsung has added a bunch of different clock faces. So head over to your clock face application or your clock face or clock style settings in the main setting application. Swipe all the way at the end, you have this new clock face icon, which includes all the new clock faces. So as you can see, we have this speedometer, this one. One of my favorite one is the one I'm using actually right now. Let me just show you guys here real quick. Yes, this one. This is the favorite one. With this, really looks awesome with the time, and I really like how it represents the battery time here. The text ones can be customizable just a little bit. We can move the text to left and right by pressing these three keys. You can customize the colors as well to whatever the color you want, or you can set it to this one, which basically optimizes the colors according to the wallpapers, so which is really cool. And again, same thing can be applied to the always on screen area. So again, you get it at the end of your clock styles. As you go inside, you see all the new clock faces which Samsung will eventually introduce with the future Samsung Experience UI, based on Android 9.0. So thank you so much for watching this full first sneak peek of the gesture-based system that is coming eventually with a future Android 9.0 Samsung Experience UI. I'm super excited for that. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below, what you think about Samsung's implementation of the gestures through the edge display, which is quite different compared to what we have with the Pixel or the iPhone X. I really like the Samsung way because they're, you know, doing something different, not just having this thing at the bottom like every other third-party manufacturer is doing. So let me know your thoughts down in the comment section. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Make sure to follow me on Instagram and Twitter, and I will see you guys in the next one. Peace out.